happening on Sunday next week. We are doing a recap. So big winners and losers, fashion blunders and all that. It's always fun. You wouldn't want to miss that. But for now, we continue to review the nominees. Enjoy this one.
First up is the British comedy, The Best Exotic Marigold Hotel. Judi Dench, Maggie Smith, Tom Wilkinson, and Bill Nye stars as a group of British retirees who decide to outsource their retirement to exotic and less expensive India. They are soon lured by advertisements for the newly restored Marigold Hotel and imagine a life of leisure in lush surroundings. However, when they arrive, they find that the Marigold is actually a shell of its former self. Although their new home is not quite what they had imagined, they learn new lessons. They find that life and love can begin again when they let go of their pasts. The film received positive reviews by critics, which described it as a sweet story featuring a top-notch cast of veteran actors. Judi Dench and Smith especially both received favorable reviews by critics.
So, give us a refund.
Of course, I'll refund you completely.
You will?
I most definitely will, straight away in 3 months, okay?
You all right?
Just want a glass of water.
That was a gin and tonic.
I know that now.
I have a dream, Mummy G. Everything will be all right in the end. So if it is not all right, it is not yet the end.
Tom Hooper's musical drama, Les Miserables, is also up for a Golden Globe. The movie features an all-star cast, including Hugh Jackman, Russell Crowe, and Anne Hathaway. Set in 19th century France, Jackman plays ex-prisoner Jean Valjean, who is hunted for decades for breaking his parole by a ruthless policeman, played by Crowe. When Valjean agrees to care for factory worker Fantine's younger daughter, Cosette, their lives change forever. Up next is Wes Anderson's comedy, Moonrise Kingdom. The film features an ensemble cast including Bruce Willis, Bill Murray, and Tilda Swinton. Set on an island off the coast of New England in the summer of 1965, Moonrise Kingdom tells a story of two 12-year-olds who fall in love, make a secret pact, and run away together into the wilderness. As various authorities try to hunt them down, a violent storm is brewing offshore, and the peaceful island community is turned upside down in more ways than anyone can handle. Moonrise Kingdom received widespread critical acclaim. Review website Rotten Tomatoes gave the film a rare rating of 94%.
How are you?
Right here.
Does it concern you that your daughter's just run away from home?
That's a loaded question. Until help arrives, I'm deputizing the little guy, the skinny one, and the boy with the patch on his eye to come with me in the station wagon.
Up next is Salmon Fishing in the Yemen, starring Ewan McGregor and Emily Blunt. The story follows Britain's leading fisheries expert, who is approached by a consultant to help realize a sheikh's vision of bringing the sport of fly fishing to the desert. Although he immediately thinks the project is both absurd and unachievable, the Prime Minister's overzealous press secretary latches onto it as a goodwill story. This unlikely team then puts it all on the line and embark on an upstream journey of faith and fish to prove the impossible possible. The film received generally favorable reviews from critics. The Los Angeles Times called the film a pleasant fantasy and a charming film whose few attempts at seriousness are best forgotten or ignored.
You think I'm mad?
It would be a miracle if it were to happen.
I feel like I've been stuck for years. I'm genetically programmed to return to dull pedestrian life.
Unless you do this with an open heart, I don't think anything will come of it.
We must have faith, Dr. Alfred.
Extremely well.
It's an extraordinary idea.
I wasn't talking about the project.
No,
I'm not sure that I was.
And last but not least, also nominated for Best Comedy is Silver Linings Playbook, starring Bradley Cooper and Jennifer Lawrence. The film is about a man named Pat with anger issues who ends up bonding with a unique girl named Tiffany. In the film, Pat has lost everything, his house, his job, and his wife. He now finds himself living back with his mother and father after spending 8 months in a state institution on a plea bargain. Pat is determined to rebuild his life, remain positive, and reunite with his wife despite the challenging circumstances of their separation. All Pat's parents want is for him to get back on his feet and to share their family's obsession with the Philadelphia Eagles football team. When Pat meets Tiffany, a mysterious girl with problems of her own, things get complicated. Tiffany offers to help Pat reconnect with his wife, but only if he'll do something very important for her in return. As their deal plays out, an unexpected bond begins to form between them, and silver linings appear in both of their lives.
Problem? I just got fired, actually.
Oh, really? How?
By having sex with everybody in the office.
Everybody?
I was very depressed after Tommy died.
We don't have to talk about it.
Thanks.
How many were there?
Oh, she's a mess. You gotta be careful.